kembo kembo na tata nzambi ya mazulu. In the holy name of our great king
malaki makungu malaki makembo isaya kungu and salama to all brothers and sisters who follow the way of the Koma, the way of the Bible. I mean Bantu people, ancient Israelite, known as ancient Israelite people, dispersed beyond the river of Ethiopia and captive among nations on the four corners of the earth. Dispersed beyond the river of Ethiopia, as written in the book of Isaiah 18, chapter from 1 to 7, and in the book of Zephaniah, the third chapter from 10 to 20. So, salama and beluka to all brothers and sisters who are feeding our brothers and sisters all over the world, Bantu people, the holy people, our brothers and sisters who are feeding them with the truth. God, Brother Chilombo and other brothers doing a good job in order to wake up our people, Bantu people, Israelite people, the holy people of the living power. So in this video, we're going to bring you understanding of the Koma. Koma means scripture. Okay? Scripture. We're going to bring you understanding of the Koma, meaning the scripture. So before we start, if you follow our video, you're going to understand many secrets. Okay? Many secrets. So we're going to start with the book of Daniel. This is King James 16:11. We're using King James 16:11. But you, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the hand. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. Knowledge shall increase. So the question is, when knowledge shall increase, and what will happen to the book? Verse 9. And he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed. The words are closed up and sealed till the time of the hand. Once again, the time of the hand. So the word will be sealed and closed. Till when? The time of the hand. So the question is, are we in the time of the hand? The answer is yes, because knowledge is increasing among the people dwelling scattered beyond the river of Kush, not Ethiopia. Okay, today Ethiopia was Abyssinia. And Kush means Nubia, ancient Nubia, beyond the river of Ethiopia, from central to South Africa, where the people known as Bantu are scattered. Why we say Bantu people? You will understand it. So, we got knowledge will increase when the time of the hand. The time of the hand. Are we in the time of the hand? Yes. So we're going to prove that. So the book is sealed, the time of the hand. Verse 10, many shall be purified and made white and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly. So, the time of the hand, what we notice, people are sanctified. When they say, many shall be purified, made white, it is sanctification. What sanctify you? The words. The words sanctify people. The words sanctify people. Isaiah said, you are sanctified by the word. The word sanctified. So the word will sanctify his people. And the people will be tried. Okay? But the wicked shall do wickedly. So the time of the end, we will notice that the wicked, who's the wicked? According to the book of Malachi, the first chapter, we find that Esau is the wicked. The border of wickedness is Esau. Esau is known as the border of wickedness. Who is Esau? The last ruler of the earth. Because according to the Apocrypha, in the book of Ezra, it is written, Esau is the end of the world, and Yakuba is the follower, the follow ruler. So Esau is the end of the world. So we are at the time of the end. What we notice, it is that many of the people of Daniel are purified, made white, and tried. Sanctification, and people are tried. People. But, however, the wicked, which is Esau, the last ruler, because Esau is the end of the world, the last ruler, if you go to the book of Badia, we call Badia Abdias, the first chapter, 21st, it is written that the fall of Esau will bring forth the rulership of the great king, the Lord. Okay, which is called the Lord. So, we come back here, you see that many shall be purified, made white, and tried. This is the process. What the elect will go through. The elect will go through this process of purification and tryness. Okay? And, but the wicked, which is Esau, shall do wickedly. He will do wickedly in his deeds. And none of the wicked shall understand. So, don't look understanding, don't seek understanding from the wicked. Even the wicked scholars, many scholars are Edomite, the wicked. Okay? They're telling you here, none of the wicked will understand. Understanding will not come from the wicked. Understanding will come from the wise. What is wise? A wise is the one who obey to the law. When you obey to the law, wisdom is given to you. When you obey to the law, wisdom is given to you. Okay? So, let's go back to 9. And he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the time of the end. So the time of the end, we're going to go to the book of Genesis to understand where are the wise in the time of the end. Where are the people of the law in this time of the end? So we're going to give you some ants. Some ants. I think ants. In French we call it, comment on appelle ça? We call it, the piste. On vous donne the piste. So we're going to give you ants to understand the time of the end. So let's go to Genesis 49. Genesis 49. And chapter 1. And Jacob called unto his sons. The sons of Jacob are the tribes of Israel. They make the tribes of Israel. and said, gather yourself together. He said to them, gather yourself together. Why he said unto them, gather yourself together? He said that I may tell you what which shall befall you in the last days. In the last days, meaning the time of the end. He told to his soul, gather yourself together. Gather yourself together. Together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days. The word here is the last days. So he's telling to his sons, gather yourself together. Gather yourself together. So we're going to see one and another scripture, Zephaniah, the second chapter and the first verse. And we will go back to what we left, meaning the book of Genesis 49. So remember, here in the book of Genesis 49, Jacob told his son, gather yourself together, okay? And here in the book of Zephaniah, the second chapter, it is written, gather yourself together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Nation not desired. What nation they're talking about? Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger comes upon you. So it is talking about his people. He's talking about his people. He's asking his people to gather together before the day of the Lord. The day of the Lord. What is the day of the Lord? Let's go to the book of Isaiah, the 13th chapter. Okay, Isaiah 13. And what is the day of the Lord? Isaiah 13 and 9. Isaiah 13 and 9. Behold, the day of the Lord comes, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, the day to lay the land desolate, he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. He shall destroy the sinners. So the day of the Lord is the day of judgment. It is the day of the judgments of fierce anger. So, we go back. It is the day of judgment and the day of the fierce anger. So, you keep it in your mind. The day of the Lord is the day of wrath, fierce anger, in order to destroy the sinners. What is sin? Sin is the breaking of the law. 1 John 3 and 4 is the breaking of the law. To which people the law was given to? Psalms 147, 19 to 20. The law was given to the people of the Most High, meaning ancient Israelite. Okay? That's in the book of Psalms 147, 19 to 20. Psalms 147, 19 to 20, it is written, he shows His word unto Yakuba, Jacob, his statutes and his judgment unto Israel. He has not dealt so with any nation. As for his judgment, they have not known them. Praise the Lord. So, we go back to Isaiah 13 and 9. Behold, the day comes, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof. Okay, so we go back to Genesis, the first chapter. Here, Yakuba said, call his sons and said, gather yourself together, that I may tell you that will shall befall you in the last days. In the last days. What Daniel called in his way the time of the hand. So the book of Zephaniah requests to his people, before the day of the Lord, gather yourself together. Okay, gather yourself together, nation, not desire. Why nation not desire? Because the hidden Ngoyi hate you. The Ngoyi hate you. Okay? According to the book of Psalms 83 chapter, the nation hate the people of the Most High, the Ngoyi, what Congo people call Ngoyi. So, that's what it is written here. The book of Genesis 49 and 1, and Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourself together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days. What will happen to his people in the last day? Where will his people be? Will his people be still in the land given unto them by Moses? No. No. So we're going to find out. Let's jump to 49:13. 49:13 concerning Zibulani. Zibulani means open in Bantu language, Congo language. So Zibulani shall dwell at the haven of the sea. The haven of the sea. It shall be a haven of ships. His borders shall be unto Zidon. So here, according to the Bible, concerning the tribes, in these last days, in the time of the hand, where the Most High requests his people to gather together before the day of the Most High, where are his people? Where are the tribes? Here concerning Zebulun, they say Zebulun shall dwell, shall is the future. Because Jacob is telling the future. Because remember, the first verses, Jacob called unto his son, said, gather yourself together, that I may tell you which shall befall you, shall befall you. Shall means future, befall you in the last days. What will be your situation, you children of the tribes, my children, Jacob is telling to his children, what will happen to you? Okay? What's happened to you? A man, his son, we got Zebulun. Zebulun is another tribe. Zebulun shall, verse 13, in the last day, where will be Zebulun? Zebulun shall dwell at the heaven of the sea. And he shall future, be for a haven of ships.
This place will be a haven of ships, if you want highway of ships.
And his border, the border of his land, he will share his border. His border will be unto Zidon. So he will share his border with Zidon. Who is Zidon? Who is Zidon? We will share border with Zebulun in the last days, before the day of the Most High. We will share border with Zebulun from the tribe of Jacob. Who will share borders, frontier, if you want. Two countries will share borders. Zebulun and Zidon. Who is Zidon? If you go to search Zidon, go to the book of Genesis, the 10th chapter. It is called Zidon with S or Z, 6th verse. And the sons of Ham, you got Cush, Mizraim, and Put, and Canaan. These are the sons of Ham. You got Cush, Mizraim, Put, and Canaan. Okay? Where do you find the sons of Ham? In Africa, known as Egypt. Because Egypt is known, according to the book of Psalms 105:23, you got the land of Ham. And the sons of Ham, you got Cush, you got Mizraim, and Put, and Canaan. When you jump to Genesis 10:15. When you jump to Genesis 10:15, you got Canaan, who is the son of Ham, Hamite, begat with Zidon. Zidon is firstborn. Zidon is written here, Zidon. So we go back to Genesis 49. What Jacob means 49, in these last days, where is Zebulun? Zebulun, one of his sons, the northern tribe, is sharing his border with Hamite in these last days, before the day of the Lord, as we have just read in Zephaniah, the second chapter, the first verse and the second verse. Okay? National desire. Where are they? They are sharing the border with Hamite here concerning Zebulun in these last days. Zebulun is sharing his border with Hamite, known as Zidon. Zidon are Hamite, according to Genesis, the 10th chapter and 15th verse. Genesis 10:15 is telling you that Zidon are Hamite from the tribe of Canaan. Canaan, okay? Canaan. So, Remember, when you see the book of Joshua, the border of Zebulun was never unto Zidon. When you see the border of Zebulun was never unto Zidon, but in these last days. However, in these last days, Zebulun is borders is unto Zidon. So Zebulun and Zidon are sharing the same frontier, the same border. The countries are close. You understand what I mean? In these last days, in the day of the end. You understand what's going on. This is important for you to understand the whereabouts of the children of Israel. Don't let people, mislead you
with fantasies,
with fairy tales. Just listen to the Bible. Here the Bible is telling you, in the last days, Zebulun is sharing his frontier, his border of his land with Zidon. He never shared his borders with Zidon before, because he shared his border with his brothers. If you see the map of ancient Zebulun, if you see the map of when he received his territory, you read the book of Joshua, the 18th chapter and the 19th chapter, Zebulun never had a border with Zidon. Never. He had never borders with Zidon. But in these last days, Zebulun is sharing his border with Zidon, where in the land of Ham. In the land of Ham. But where in the land of Ham? That is important, because the land of Ham is big a continent. And we go to 2 Ezra, the first chapter. This is Apocrypha. 2 Ezra, the first chapter. 11. It is written here, all the nation I have destroyed before them, and in the east I have scattered the people of two provinces, even Tyrus and Zidon, and have slain all the enemies. So Tyre and Zidon was scattered in the east. In the east, what is east part of the land of Ham? So where is the children of Zidon in these last days? In east of the land of Ham, meaning East Africa. East Africa, you will find them. In East Africa, sharing the border with Zebulun. Zebulun, who are the children of Jacob. So the question is, where are the children of Israel today? So we have already broke it down in other videos. So let's remember, the book of Daniel told us in last days, knowledge shall increase among the wise, but the wicked will do wickedly, and none of the wicked will understand. So understanding will not come from the wicked, because the wicked, the earth is given unto the end of the wicked. Job 9:24, the ruler is the wicked, who's ruling the world is the wicked. The wicked is ruling the world. Okay? The wicked is ruling the world. So, we got it here. Okay. Now, so we're going to sum up for the understanding of those okay. So we go back to the book of Second Ezra 6 and 9. Second Ezra 6 and 9, it is written here, Esau is the end of the world, and Yakuba is the beginning of it that follow. So Esau is the end of the world. Esau is the end of the world. So we go back, though. So this is 2 Ezra 6, 9. It is written, Esau is the end of the world. So the end of the world, the ruler of the end of the world will be Edomite. Okay? Edomite will be the ruler in these last days. In these last days. So we're going to go to the book of Malachi, the first chapter, to find out who's the wicked. So you know that in the book of Daniel, we've just read, the book of Daniel told us that many shall be purified, made white, and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly. The wicked will do wickedly. We are in the time of the end. Let's start on 9. Daniel 12 and 9. And he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the time of the end. Many shall be purified and made white and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly. None of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand. So the wicked shall not understand, but the wise shall understand. So understanding will not come from the wicked, but understanding will come from the wise. Who's the wise? The wise are the people of the Lord. Okay? The wise are the people of the world. The people of the Lord, the people of the Most High. The wise are the people of the Most High. So, the book of Malachi. Who's the wicked? Malachi, first chapter, 1 to 4. It is written, the fourth chapter, where Edom said, Edom is Esau, Esau is Edom, said, we are impoverished, and we will return and build the desolate places. Thus said the Lord of hosts. They shall build, and I will throw down, and they shall call them the border of wickedness. They shall call them the border of who will be called the border of wickedness is Edom, Esau, the people against whom the Lord has indignation forever. Righteous anger forever. So, what is written here, the border of wickedness, when you call the incarnation of wickedness is Esau. Edom is the incarnation of wickedness. Okay? Once you understand it, you come to 2 Ezra, the 6th chapter, and you go to 9. For Esau is the end of the world, meaning the border of wickedness is going to rule, going to be the ruler of the end of the world, and Yakuba is the beginning of it that follow, meaning after the fall of Esau will bring forth the rulership of Yakuba. That's what it means. So we go to the book of Genesis. Yakuba told us what's going to happen. Yakuba is Jacob, Yakuba, we call him Yakuba. Jacob told his sons what's going to happen to them in the last days. And we found out that in the last days, one of the tribe of, one of the sons of Jacob, known as Zebulun, meaning the northern tribe, will share his border with Hamite, known as Zidon, meaning they will share the same border. The countries will be closed. Okay, they will share the same borders. Okay, we have already broke down who are Zebulun. They are Bantu from Kenya. We have already broke it down in other videos. You can see French speaking videos. The Bantus of Kenya sharing borders with Hamite from Somalia, known as, you see the people of the East there, Somalia and so on. So this area was the haven of ships. It became the haven thief because of what they call it.
Geographical location in Egypt is the Suez Canal. 2 million barrels of oil pass through the canal every day, bound for the US, Europe, and Asia. Without the canal, tankers would have to go around the Horn of Africa, adding 8 weeks to the trip. Imagine what that would do to the price of oil. In addition, the U.S. Navy sends 12 warships per month through the canal, a key shortcut to Iraq and Afghanistan. Take a look at this.
Suez Canal, you see all the ships, all this area became the haven of ships because of Suez Canal. Because before, the ships were making, turning all Africa. Now, because of Suez Canal, in these last days, you see all ships are going harbor to cross the Suez Canal. It is artificial canal made by French and British to split Africa from the what's called Middle East. Okay, Suez Canal for the ships. It became the haven of ships. All this eastern African area. So where you see banter from Kenya, known as what is the name? Gikuyu. Gikuyu people are people from Zebulon. We have our, and we broke it down for you. We broke it down for you in our French-speaking video. So they're sharing the borders with Canaanite from Somalia and so on, Ethiopia. Where you see Ethiopia? Ethiopia was Abyssinia. It is not ancient Nubia. So people mistake when you see Ethiopian people. Oh, this is Kushite. No, I see many people saying that Ethiopians are Kushite. No, they are not Kushite. They're Canaanite. They're Barashit mixed with Berber people who are Moabite and Ammonite. We have already broke it down for you. So, the keywords here in these last days, when we see the rulership of the wicked with Esau, because according to 2 Ezra, the Apocrypha, the 6th chapter and 9, 6 and 9, Esau is the end of the world. So Esau is the end of the world. Job 9:24. The earth is given unto the end of the wicked, who is Esau. So we are living the rulership of Esau. We are living the end of the world, Yakuba was telling us. The rulership of Esau, meaning the end of the world. So we come back to Genesis 49:1. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourself together, I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days. So the last days means the end of the world. The last days means the end of the world, meaning the rulership of the wicked. Who's the wicked? According to Malachi 1:4, it is the board of the wickedness is Esau, Edom. So what will happen to the son of Jacob during the days of the rulership of Esau, the wicked? That's what he's telling you here. And verse 13, where is the northern tribe? Verse 13, Zebulun shall dwell at the heaven of the sea and shall be for an haven of ships, and his border shall be unto Zidon. So one of his border will be unto his brothers, band to brothers. May another border, but this is singular, Another border will be unto who? Unto Zidon, meaning Hamite. Hamite Zidon, according to Genesis 10 and 15, Zidon, her Hamite from the tribe of Canaan. They are Canaanite. So, we got it now. We understand that Zebulun is living in the land of Ham. The land of Ham, known as Egypt. It's North Africa, Egypt. According to the book of Psalms 105, 23, the land of Ham is Africa. So, we got it here. The children of Israel are in Africa. That's the Bible is telling us here. There is no mistake. You got it? There is no mistake. But the question is, in Africa, you got many tribes. Not all of them are the children of Israel. So we have to look for the children of Israel according to words, to the language, because if they are the children of Israel, they might speak English, they might speak Hebrew, they are Semite. Semite speaks Semite language. So, we have already given you information concerning the book of Abbé Proyard and other writers concerning Bantu people, Bantu are Semite people. The only Semite living in Africa are Bantu people. So we're going to check other prophecies, if other prophecies back up the fact that the children of Israel are among Hamite, are sharing borders with Hamite, are beyond the river of Ethiopia, are in the land of Ham, that's other tribe in the land of Ham. So we're going to start with the book of Isaiah, 66 chapter. We have already read it for you, but for the purpose of understanding, we're going to read it again. So this is Isaiah 66 chapter. It starts on Isaiah 66. We start with 15. You go to Isaiah 66, you start 15. Okay. So this is the day of the descriptions of the day of the Lord. We have just read in the book of Zephaniah, the second chapter, 1-3 verses. It is written, gather yourself together, national desire, meaning talking about the children of Israel, before the day of the Lord. So they have to gather together before the day of the Lord. So this is concerning the day of the Lord. Where the children of Israel will be, where the Lord will find his people, his tribe, the tribes are going to find them. Will the Lord find his people in the land he gave to their fathers? I don't think so. When you sin, you become dispersed, because dispersion is a curse, according to the book of Deuteronomy 64, it is written that dispersion is a curse, because the book of Deuteronomy 28 is split in two parts. You got the first chapter to 14, you got blessing, and 15 to 68, you got curses. Okay? You got curses. So 64 is among curses. You read the book of Deuteronomy 64, it is written, a dispersion is a curse. Remember, dispersion is a curse. When a people is dispersed, it is a curse. It is a curse. You remember this word. So, we are in the book of Isaiah 66. We are in the book of Isaiah 66 from 15 to 20. We're going to give you understanding. It is written here, for behold, the Lord will come with fire. The Lord will come with fire and with his chariot, like a whirlwind, to render his anger and fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. We have already read these words in the book of Zephaniah, the second chapter we just read, concerning the day of the Lord. This is the day of the Lord. The question is where the Lord will find his people. Okay, where the Lord will find his people in the day of his anger. We are Isaiah 66:16. For by fire, okay, let me zoom a little bit. Okay. Now each of you can read. So we're going to read back. We are in Isaiah 66:15. For behold, the day the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire, by his sword, will the Lord plead with all flesh. And the slain of the Lord shall be many. So he's coming to kill people. He's not coming to hug people. Okay, if you are a sinner, we have just read it in Isaiah 13 and 9. He's coming to judge, to kill people, and to gather nations. That the book of Joel, the first chapter, to gather nations in the valley of Yahosifa. The word Yahosifa, it's the same word Ben to use concerning judgment, Sifa. Misifa is the same word Bantu people used for judgment, Congo people, Misifa. Okay, Misifa means judgment. So, Yahosifa, in the valley of Yahosifa, he will gather the nation to deal with them, judge them concerning his people. So, we go back to, we are in Isaiah 66:15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with chariot like a whirlwind, to render his anger and fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire, by his sword, will the Lord plead with all flesh. And the slain of the Lord shall be many. They that sanctify, the Lord is Congo, the archangel Congo. The archangel Yakongo is coming. His name is Yakongo. We're going to prove it. They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the garden behind one of the tree in the middle of eating swine flesh and the abomination, the mouse shall be consumed together, said Yakong, the Lord Yakong. Okay, so he's coming to kill those who don't respect Levitical laws on dietary, don't eat pork, but you eat pork, okay? It's coming to kill all those who eat swine flesh and all abomination written in the book of, you got the book of Leviticus 11 chapter to understand dietary laws. So you have to keep dietary laws. Even if the wicked, who is Edom, who is telling you, oh, the law is done away with. Don't, the law is important for you. Okay? Okay, if you read the book of Matthew, the 5th chapter, 17, it is explained what concerning the law. You have to remember the law of the Most High. Those who teach the law and those who keep the law will be rewarded. Matthew, the 5th chapter, from 17 to 19. Those who teach the law and those who keep the law will be rewarded. Okay? Will be rewarded. Will be praised. Okay. So, Isaiah 66:18, I know their works, their thoughts. It shall come and I will gather all nations and tongues. They shall come and see my glory. My glory. Okay? I will set a sign among them. I will send those who escape unto the nation, Tarshish, and so on. Let's jump on 20. And they shall bring all your brethren for an offering unto the Lord out of the nation, unto houses and chariots, literaries, to my holy mountains, Jerusalem, we call it Salama, said Yakum, the Lord, as the children of Israel bring an offering in a clean vessel into the house of the Lord. So when the Lord will come back, the children of Israel will bring offering in a clean vessel unto the Lord. Where will they come from bringing offering in a clean vessel, as written here? We're going to find out where will they come from. So remember, they will bring offering. We're going to see another prophet will prophesy concerning offering in a clean vessel in the holy mountain. The children of Israel will bring offering. We go to the book of Ikesa means Ezekiel, and his name was Ikesa in a Bantu language. 20. We're going to go to the book of Ezekiel 20 chapter. You take the scripture, you keep them, and you will make your comparison. It's a little bit slow. Bear me a minute. So we are in the book of Ezekiel 20, and we go to 40. It is written here, only my holy mountains. Keep the word holy mountains. For in my holy mountains, in the mountains of the height of Israel, said the Lord of power, meaning Yakongo, they shall all the house of Israel, all the house of Israel. When you say all the house of Israel, meaning all the tribes, all of them in the land serve me, they will serve me, and I will accept them, and I will require your offerings. I will require your offerings and the first fruit of your oblation, all holy things. So the children of Israel will be required offerings. They will bring offerings in the clean vessel, as we have just read in the book of Isaiah 66:20. So we're going to go to another prophet, only Isaiah 18 chapter. The children of Israel will bring offering. Where will they come from? We're going to go to Malachi. Malachi, the third chapter, will say the same thing. So you notice that many of the prophets, there is a meeting between Yakongo, the Holy One, who's coming, the Archangel Makaya, because it is another name from Bantu. Bantu used the word Makaya. Makaya is a Bantu word. Makai means non-the-chef, meaning the great chief, the chief. It is written in the book of Daniel, the chief Makai. What you call Michael. Bantu call it Makaya is the name of a chief, okay, in Congo dictionary. So, we are in the book of Malachi, the third chapter. Malachi, the third chapter. Okay. Okay. So, the first verse, behold, I will send my messenger, he shall prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come in his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom you delight. Behold, he shall come, and say the Lord of hosts. The messenger of the covenant, meaning Malachi. Malachi means messenger. It also means angel. Malachi. It is an old Congo word. Malachi means holder. In Congo words, great king. Okay? Malachi, okay. We call it Malachi Mambeli. Berit, the letter R got the sound of L in Congo language, in Hebrew, Congo. So Mbeli, Malachi Mambeli. Malachi Mambeli means, Malachi Mambeli, we call it Malachi Mambeli, means the angel of the covenant. The angel of the covenant is the one Massa, Moses, met when you read the book of Exodus, the first chapter, and the fourth, and the sixth. Moses didn't meet God, he met the angel of the covenant, meaning Malachi Mambeli. Malachi Mambeli. So, that's another subject. We don't want to mess everything, okay? So, but who may abide in the day of his coming? Who shall stand when he appears? So, who may abide when he comes, the day of his coming? Malachi Mambeli, meaning the angel of covenant. Who will stand when he is like a refinery fire, like a full soap? He shall sit as a refiner, a purifier of silver. He shall purify the son of Levi and purge them as a gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. An offering in righteousness. So if you see the word offering, I've just told you, is menga. Menga is the same word Bantu use, Congo use for her offering. The only people who use this word offering are Congo people. Menka. We have already shown you this word menka. Menka is a Congo word. The only people who use this word menka are the people beyond the river of Ethiopia. Means as Congo people. Menka. This is the word minka for offering. You find this word in the book of Isaiah 66 chapter, the book of, we just read, Ezekiel 20 and 40. The same word used is minka, offering. Offering, the only people who use this word offering, minka, is the people living beyond the river of Ethiopia, known as Congo people, Bantu people. Congo people use this word minka. We have just shown you in other videos, you have already know these words. So you see that the people living beyond the river of Ethiopia are the people of the Most High, the people of the written Bible, the people of the Holy One. None of you, you will understand in later days when the Most High will appear. The question here, it is written in the book of Malachi, the first chapter, the fourth chapter. Okay? It is there, we will stand when he comes. We will stand when he appears. The word appear is very important. The word appears, the synonym is coming. To come. Remember the word to come. To come. To come. Remember the word to come. He's coming. Come. Appear is the synonym of come. Okay? Remember the word come and appear. So, then the offering of Yaounde, meaning Judah, and Salama, Jerusalem, be pleasant to the Lord, meaning Yakongo, as in the days of old and former years. So, as in the days of old, who was with Moses, with Massa, giving instructions concerning offerings, it was the same Malachi Mambeli, meaning Malachi Mambeli, meaning Malachi Mambeli, meaning the angel of the covenant. It is the angel of the covenant who was there. The angel of the covenant is the one who gives instructions to the people. Okay? Using Moses to give instruction to the people. Like in the days of old, he will do the same thing. And when you read in the book of Daniel, the first chapter, it is an archangel who's coming. Who's coming to deliver his people. So if you're waiting for another man, you're wasting your time, okay? Call nobody master, chief. There is only one chief. You can't have two chiefs in heaven, okay? The one who's coming, his name is an archangel, Malachi Makungu, Malachi Makungu. And we're going to open your eyes. So, as you can see written here, it is clear that Malachi Makungu, an angel, is coming. When you see the word messenger of covenant, it means the angel of covenant, whom you delight. So, this angel of covenant is the one the people beyond the river of Ethiopia was calling. So we come back to Malachi, the first chapter. You will see the Malachi Maka, Malachi Mambeli, because the letter R, the resh, the Hebrew resh, is pronounced by Bantu people as R. Some Bantu pronounce it as R. You got, for example, Bantu from Rwanda call Rwanda with R, Rwanda. Utu Bantu, not the Hemite known as Tutsi. Tutsi are Hemite. But Utu Bantu gave the name of Rwanda as Rwanda with R. When you come to western part of Bantu, Angola, the capital is Luanda. You see, it is used the letter L, Luanda, Rwanda. It is the same word. But you see L instead of R. Okay? So that's why you see here, Berit, it is pronounced by Bantu Mbeli. This word alliance, covenant, Mbeli, is come from the word alliance with, what they call it, the covenant of with Abraham, what you call Abraham concerning circumcision, it was made with a knife. So Bantu called Mbeli is the knife. Okay, so the covenant of the knife, it was written Mbeli, B, R, you put L, and you got the Y, Yod, and the thought is not pronounced on the hand of the word concerning Hebrew Bantu. We're going to show you Hebrew Bantu, how to speak Hebrew Bantu later, but you have to get some knowledge, okay? That's not the subject. So they call here in the book of Malachi, the great messenger is coming, the one who's coming, his name is the angel of covenant, the messenger of covenant, meaning the angel of covenant. Malachi Mambeli, the angel of covenant or the messenger of covenant. So you see, we call it Malachi. Yeah? Malachi means king, means holder in Bantu language, in Congo language, Malachi. Malachi. So Malachi, we use this word as Malachi, order, or king, above, and so on. So, you see, messenger, you got angel also. It means angels, it means messenger. You can translate it as angel or messenger. So when they say the messenger of covenant, means the angel of covenant, is the one who was with Moses during all his doing. Okay? He got the name of the Most High. So, these angels, people of Congo call him in many different names. Okay? Before the white man came in the Bantu area, his name was known as different. So, we're going to give you the name how the people beyond the river of Ethiopia was calling these angels. So his name is Kongo. So you see many Bantu ethnic call him in different name. You got Shede Bakongo and Bangala, they call him Kongo or Akongo. So Lunda people call him to Kongo, Basuku people, Bayaka, calling many Congo, and Baluba, Bakuba, Bakuba and Bushu call him Kakongo. People from Kasai and Katanga call him Kongolo. And people from Boshi, Kuvert from Republic of Congo, call him Ikongolo. And you got other Bantu ethnic people from Batetela of Sanguru, call him Okita Congo. You got Mongo people and Chwapa, call him Iyala Congo. You got Manyema from Lualaba, call him Bakongola. Bakongola. This is the angel of covenant. Because before the coming of white people in Africa, you should know that Bantu people had a chief angels. They call him archangels, Akongo or Kongo, archangel. It is the only people in the world who got above them an archangel. Okay, an archangel. All Africa, African Hermit people, they got their statues to worship. They were doing voodoo, Hermit people, voodoo, and so on. But when you come beyond the river of Ethiopia, they got a chief, an archangel, whose name was Kongo. And what is important here, you got Lukalo and Hutu people from Rwanda call him Gikongoro. Mikongo people from Gabon, the center of Gabon, call him Mikongo. So the purpose is his name is Kongo with different sound. People from Maniema call him Bakongola. So you got many names. Bakongola, Kongo. So his name is Kongo. Kongo. But you're going to ask yourself, can we find this word Kongo in the Bible? I don't find it in the Bible. People will say, but what is his name? He's coming with strange name. So be patient. We're going to show you more. So here we see that the messenger of covenant is an angel of covenant who's coming. He's going to refine and he's going to request offering from his people. So the people of the Most High will be requested what they call offerings. And the word offering means menka, menga or menka. It is the same word used by Congo people beyond the river of Ethiopia. Congo people were led captive among nations, Congo. Congo people, in the Congo dictionary, menka means offering. Okay, so this is the book of Isaiah 18th chapter. If you go to Isaiah 18th chapter, it is a woe to the land chattering with wings. Woe means cursing. The land beyond the river of Ethiopia is under a curse. That's what they're telling. Woe to the land. Woe means curse, meaning something cursed. The land which is behind the river of Ethiopia. Why this land is cursed? Why there is a curse? Because the word woe means woe to the land, chattering with wings, which is behind the river of Kush, meaning Ethiopia. The word is not Ethiopia. When you see the Bible, it is a mistranslation of Kush. You see the word is Kush here, not Ethiopia. Today, Ethiopia was Abyssinia. Don't make mistake. You see the map of Ethiopia, you say, beyond the river of Ethiopia means, I see Ethiopia here. No, Kush was Nubia. It was a big area, the southern part of it was the south of Egypt, okay? It's a big area in West Africa, all this area. And beyond the reef of Ethiopia, of Nubia, you got Central Africa, and it leads you to South Africa, where you see Bantu people. So The problem is the land beyond the river of Kush. The word is used is wo. Wo. You see the word wo. Translate, its translation here means asla wo, wo. Wo, if you see the definition of wo, it means what? So we're going to go to synonym. We're going to put the word wo. Okay. Wo, it's going to give us synonym of the word wo. We're going to check it. Bear me a minute. It's just a little bit slow. Okay. So wo, this is the synonym of wo, means this. Distress, tragedy, trouble, adversity, calamity, disaster, misery, curse. You see curse? This is the synonym of the word woe. Curse, misery, sorrow, sadness, tribulation. You got the word tribulation. You go to Revelation 2 and 9, I know that you have tribulation. So it is distress. What means distress? There is tribulations, suffering, catching hell if you want, trouble, misery, misfortune, depression, curse. You see the word woe. Okay? So we come back to Isaiah 18 chapter. Where was? Okay, sorry. I lost it. So we see the word war means distress, tribulations, catching hell if you want. So woe to the land shuddering with wings, which is beyond the river of Ethiopia. So okay. What is said to the people beyond the river of Ethiopia? Ethiopia are called to bring forth offering. Verse 7, it is in that time the present shall be brought to the Lord of hosts of the people scattered and peeled from the people terrible from the beginning, a nation met it out and trodden under the foot, whose lands rivers have spread to the place of the name of the Lord of hosts, to the mountain of Zion. So these people dwelling beyond the river of Ethiopia who are catching hell, war means catching hell, the land, they're catching hell in this land, woe to the land shuddering with wings, which is beyond the river of Ethiopia, catching hell with tribulations and so on. These people will bring forth present, they are the scattered and peeled, the web. Terrible people, because the monster was dealing them with the word terrible. A nation met it how trodden down underfoot, okay, whose rivers have spoiled, and the place of the name of the Lord, the mountain. So they will bring forth offering. They will bring present to the Most High, okay? They will bring present to the Most High. The same people we have just told you, okay? So, we've just checked that the people living beyond the river of Ethiopia will bring forth present offering to Mount Zion when the Most High comes back. Okay? That's what we have just checked now. So now we're going to go to another scripture, the book of Zephaniah. Zephaniah, the first chapter. We have already broke it down for you in other videos. Now we're going to give you an other understanding. Excuse my English, is not as perfect as you can expect. I'm trying to do my best. So here again, it starts with woe. To her that is filthy and polluted, the oppressing city. Okay? Her princes, which are roaring lions, is talking about Salama here. So we jump on 8. 8. Therefore, wait upon me, said the Lord, until the day I rise up, meaning he will appear, to the prayer, for my determination is to gather the nation, that assembly of the kingdoms, to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger. For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. So you remember, we have just read the same scripture in Isaiah 66 from 15 to 20. It is the same scripture. The prophet is just saying the same thing we have just read on Isaiah 66, 15 to 20. So here in the book of Zephaniah, he's saying the same thing. The day of is coming back, is coming back. The day when the book of Malachi say that the angels, the messenger of the covenant, the angel of the covenant will appear. The angel of the covenant is the same Daniel, the first chapter, same. He gave his name. What's bent to use? Micaiah. Bent to call him Micaiah as the great chief. If you see the book of Daniel, they call him the great chief. And bent to call from Congo, call Micaiah. The word Micaiah means the great chief. What you call Michael. Okay? So we come back here. Where was I? Okay. So we are in the book of Zephaniah. Therefore, wait for me. Wait upon me. Wait ye upon me, said the Lord. Yakongo, his name is Yakongo, until the day that I rise up to the prayer, for my determination is to gather all the nations that I may assemble the kingdoms to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger, And all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. Meaning judgment. This is judgment. Okay? The day of the Lord, we have just read in Isaiah 13 and 9 chapter. Day of the Lord. From beyond, We are verse 9. For I will turn to the people a pure language that they may call upon the name of the Lord to serve him with one consent. So he will turn his people a pure language. He will turn his people a pure language. We have already broken it down in other videos, French-speaking videos, to serve him with one consent, in order for his people to serve him. The verb serve, from the verb serve, you get the verb servant. The first chapter 9, for then I will turn to the people a pure language, that they may all call upon the name of the Lord to serve him with one consent. Meaning, it is talking about the servant of the Lord. Isaiah 44:1, Jacob, Israel, my servant. It is talking about the children of Israel. Okay? So, now you go from behind the river for Ethiopia. From beyond the river of Ethiopia. Once again, the word here is not the word here is not Ethiopia. You're gonna check. The word here is not Ethiopia. From beyond the river of Ethiopia, the word is Cush. You see Cush? It is the same word we've just told you. Cush means Nubia. Nubia means the great Nubia. Okay? It's not Ethiopia. It is a mistranslation. The word is Cush. You got the word Dala, attempt. My suppliant means worshippers. My worshippers. So once again, we put the word worshipper. Suppliant means the tongue. My worshippers, adorer, you got the word adorer, supplicant, devoted person, devoted, okay? Adoro, you got church congregation, congregate, pious person, devoted, you got addict, adherent, believer, disciples, lover, supporter, amateur. You got all these names. Booster, believer, followers, disciples, adherent, lover. Okay? That's what it means. My followers, my believers. These hard names only belongs to the children of Israel. So my worshipers, the word would be here is my worshipers. My worshipers. That's the word which supposed to be here. Not suppliant. It can be suppliant, my worshipers. The word here, my worshipers. My worshipers, even the door of my dispersed. We remember dispersion means a curse. If they are dispersed, then because they are cursed, they broke the laws of the Most High. When they call them a dispersed, dispersion is a curse according to the book of Deuteronomy 28:64. So, these people who are dispersed beyond the river of Ethiopia will bring offering. Will bring what offering? Where? We're going to find out where they're going to bring offering. Once again, the word offering here is menka. Menka, the only people who use menka beyond the river of Ethiopia, we found out, is Congo people. Congo people use the word menka for offering. It is the same word Congo people use for offering. The only people beyond the river of Ethiopia who use the word offering for menka, it is the Congo people. So once again, we go back to them from beyond the river of Ethiopia. My suppliant, meaning my worshippers, even the daughter of my dispersed, shall bring my offering. In that day, he's telling to the people dispersed beyond the river of Ethiopia, you shall not be ashamed of all that doing. Why they shall not be ashamed? We have just read it last time, because salvation is coming for them. Okay? Salvation is coming unto them. Why they shall not be ashamed? Because salvation is coming unto them. Okay, just a minute, bear me a minute. So, when you go, let's go to Isaiah 45. Well, why they shall not be ashamed? It is in that day, the people living beyond the river of Ethiopia, it is said that you shall not be ashamed of thy doing. Of thy doing. Why they shall not be ashamed? Isaiah 45:17. For Israel shall be saved in the Lord, Yakongo, with everlasting salvation. You shall not be ashamed, nor confounded, word without hand. Because salvation is for them, for the people dwelling scattered beyond the river of Ethiopia. Isaiah 14. You shall not be ashamed, because you shall be saved with everlasting salvation. That's why. Where you have transgressed against me. What is transgression? It is the breaking of the law. 1 John 3 and 4. To which people the law is given to the children of Israel. If you go to Psalms 147, 19 to 20, the law was given to the children of Israel only. This thing is not talking about West Africans. Hamite from West Africa, who are Egyptian. It's not talking about East African Hamite. He's talking about the people dwelling beyond the river of Ethiopia, known as Bantu Semite people. Okay? So, it is not talking about all black people. All black people. It's talking about specific people living beyond the river of Ethiopia. So, we come back to Zephaniah 3 and 10. In that day you shall not be ashamed of your doing while you have transgressed against me. Okay? For then I will take away in the midst of thee them that rejoice in thy pride. So now he's talking about a proud tribe among the dispersed of the children of Israel. What people who was proud among the children of Israel, we're going to find out. Isaiah 28, now he's talking about the proud among the tribe living beyond the river of Ethiopia. You go to Isaiah 28, it is written, woe to the crown of pride, to the drunkard of Ephraim, Ephraim, whose glorious beauty is fading flower, which are the herd of the fat valleys, of them that are overcome with wine. Okay? With wine. And verse 3, the crown of pride, the drunkards of Ephraim, shall be trodden under feet. So, the pride, the proud of pride, the proud of pride is Ephraim. Ephraim is the proud of crown. It's talking about the northern tribes. Remember, the northern tribe is the crown of pride. That's why it is written here in Zephaniah 3:11, in that day, talking about the people beyond the river of Ethiopia, you shall not be ashamed of thy doing. Why? Because they will be saved with everlasting salvation, according to Isaiah 45:17. And where you have transgressed against me, when Ephraim transgressed against the Most High, because they are accused of transgression against the Most High. Where Ephraim transgressed against the Most High? The question, because we have found out the pride tribe is Ephraim. So the question is, when Ephraim transgressed against the Most High, because they're accusing Ephraim here of transgression against the Most High. Who is Ephraim? We call him Pelahi. Pelahi, meaning Epela. Okay. Well, so you go to the book of Hosea. So we go, so in that day you shall not be ashamed of that doing. We have just read that concerning, if they're going to be saved, they're going to be not ashamed. Concerning Isaiah 45:17, they will be saved by the Lord, everlasting salvation. Where you have transgressed against me, when they transgressed against the Most High, you go to Hosea, the 7th chapter 11, it is written, Ephraim also is like a silly dove without heart. They call to Egypt, they go to Assyria. When they shall go, I will spread my net upon them, I will bring them down as a flower to the heaven. I will chastise them as the congregation has heard. Woe unto them, meaning unto Ephraim, the northern tribe. Woe unto them, for they have fled from me, destruction unto them, because they have transgressed against me. 13, they have transgressed against me. They have transgressed against me. Though I have redeemed them, they have spoken lies against me. They have spoken lies against me. You see, it is the same sentences written by Hosea 7:11-13 concerning the northern tribe. So when you come back here, when they say, well, you have transgressed against me, it refers to Ephraim, the transgressor. So you see, it's talking about Ephraim. Another hint. For then I will take away out of the midst of thee them that rejoice in thy pride. So this tribe, Ephraim, the northern tribe, is known by his pride. We have just read it in the book of Isaiah 28, from 1 to 3. The crown of pride is Ephraim. And you shall no more be haughty, another word to refer to pride, because of my holy mountain. You shall no more be haughty because of my holy mountains. When you read on, it is called Zion. Sing, O daughter of Zion, O Israel, be glad and rejoice, O daughter of Salem. So the people beyond the river of Ethiopia, verse 3:14, are called the daughter of Zion, Israel. They call them Israel. Okay? This is the people beyond the river of Ethiopia. So, therefore, people will ask themselves, but why are you calling these angels Congo, 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 Congo? But we have already broken down the word Congo. Come from the Hebrew word means belt. Belt means truth, according to Ephesians. We go to the book of Ephesians. Would you bear me a minute? Ephesians 6. So angels got spiritual names, okay? So while angel got spiritual name. So, can we find important information concerning? Okay. So, the girt means belt. When you put girt. Okay. See here, just girt means belt. Okay, belt and so on. So Ephesians 6:14, stand therefore having your loins girt about with the truth. So girt is a symbol of truth. Okay? Girt is a symbol of truth. Okay. So when you come to the Bible, when you see the Bible, we will give you important information. Let's go back to Ephesians. So Ephesians has just told, what is his name? We're going to go to Revelation 19 and find out what is his name. So Revelation 19:13 will give us the name of the Lord, the secret name of the Lord. Revelation 19 give us that he was clothed with a vesture. Remember, clothed means Congo. When you come to Congo here, blue letter, you got H2289. You have Congo. We have just break it down. Congo means girt, clothed, girded, and girt. Girt means belt. You dig what I mean? Belt. Clothed, girded, and belt means Congo. Congo is the belt. Remember, in the book of Ephesians, we have just read 6:14. The belt, the girt, is a symbol of truth. It also means symbolize the truth, because angels got symbolic names. They don't have names like us. They got symbolic names. Okay? So, remember, his people beyond the river of Ethiopia called the archangels who delivered them out of Egypt, they call him Kango, Akongo, Kangolo, Kangola, and so on, in many different forms of Congo. Okay? So, now we understand that his name is called the Word of God. Because here in Revelation 19 and 30, the name of the Lord is given as like this. And he was clothed, meaning Kango, with a vesture dipped in blood, dipped with the blood of Esau. You will understand in the book of Isaiah, they explain why his blood, his vesture is dipped with blood. And his name is called the Word of God. So you got his name as the Word of God. What is the Word of God? This is his name, the Word of God. You go to John 17:17. They will tell you what the Word of God means, because it is breaking down what the Word of God means. The book of John 17:17. We're going to find out what the Word of God means. John 17:17. It is written like this: sanctify them through thy truth, thy word is truth. Meaning, the Word of God means the truth. You understand what that means? The Word of God means the truth. Okay? So, now you know that in the book of Psalms, the law means also the truth. Psalms 119:142. So now we know that his name means also the truth. So we're going to find out what will be the name his name. Okay. So we're gonna go to understand the deepness of his name. So we're gonna go to Revelation 3:12 to find out, to get more information concerning his name. So we're going to go to Revelation 3:12. Okay, we're going to go to Revelation 3:12. It is written here, behold, I come quickly, hold that fast which you have, that no man take thy crown. Him that overcome will I make a pillar in the temple of my God. He shall go no more out. I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem. So, listen carefully. The city of my God, which is New Jerusalem. So, he that overcome, he said, I will give a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. I will write upon him the name of my God, the name of his God, and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which comes down out of heaven from my God. I will write upon him my new name. What is my new name? Because the name here, if you see new, means. So we know that he got the same name like the name of his God. You remember when the Most High told to his angels, he told him, be careful of these angels, he got my name. This the Most High told to Moses, be careful of these angels, he bore my name. You remember, Okay, remember this. He told to Moses in the book of Exodus. He told, be careful of these angels. He hold my name. He got my name. So here we find that. He said that. Him that overcome, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God. He shall go no more out. I will write upon him the name of my God. He will write upon him, his elect, the name of his God and the name of the city of my God. So they will have the name of God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem. So the name of the city of his God, it is New Jerusalem, which comes from out of heaven, from my God. I will write upon him my new name. So let's find out to get hints concerning this New Jerusalem name. What will be the name of the New Jerusalem? So that's the question. What will be the name of the New Jerusalem, which is the name of God and the name of his God and his name, his new name? So we go to the book of Zechariah. Take the book of Zechariah, chapter 8, and the third verses. Zechariah 8 and 3. So now you got the name of Zechariah 8 and 3. Thus said the Lord, meaning Yaakov, I am returned unto Zion. I will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem, and Jerusalem shall be called the city of truth. Congo. Jerusalem shall be called the city of truth. And the mountain of the Lord of hosts, the holy mountain. Jerusalem, new name, is the city of truth. Therefore, the question is, what is the truth according to Ephesians 6:14? The truth is the girt. The girt. What is the girt? The bell. What is the bell in Hebrew? Kango. 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 So the new Jerusalem name will be the city of Congo. That's why if you go to the Bible, this is a secret. We're going to finish with this. That's why when you go to the Bible, you type H22-94-95. You see here, Kangola, Kangola. You got Kangola, Kangola. Okay, Kangola. What is Kangola? You see here, Kangola. Kangola, descendant of Manasseh. Manasseh is a tribe. Descendant of Manasseh, name was Kangola. Why they give Kangola, which is a Kongola? It is Kongola. It is the name. Now you go to Jerusalem. What city you got in Jerusalem? Bait Kongola. H 1031 belongs to Jerusalem. Jerusalem belongs to who? To the tribe of Benjamin. Jerusalem belongs to the tribe of Benjamin. In Jerusalem, you got a place called Bait Kongola. Bait Kongola means House of Kongola. Why they call the place House of Kongola? Bait Kongola. Who is Kongola? Where you find Kongola? You find Kongola beyond the river of Ethiopia. Go to Wikipedia, you tap Kongola. You find it in Namibia. You find it in Cameroon. You dig what I mean? Kongola is the same name. The same name. The angel was called. The angels was called Kongola. When you see here, the different name of Kongola, the angel, the archangel Kongola. People from Maniema, Luaba, how they call the angel, the archangels? Bakongola. You see here, Bakongola. It is the same name. So, now we try to give you the truth. It's up to you to wake up. So you got here, Bait Kongola. You just type in blue letter, H, you got Kongola, H2295, you go to pronunciation, you got Kongola. Once again, you type H1031, you got Bakongola or Baikongola or Bakongola. It is here, Bakongola. Bakongola, H1031, place of Jerusalem, Bakongola means the house of Kongola. Who is Kongola? Who got the name of Kongola? You find it only beyond the river, Ethiopia. That's why in Second Ezra, the first chapter and nine, First Ezra 9 chapter, you got, this is King James 16:11. First Ezra 9, you go to 34. You got the name Nzambi here. Nzambi. Who got the name of Nzambi beyond the river of Ethiopia? Bantu people. You got such countries like Zambia. You got Mozambique. You got from Zambia. Mozambique. You got Nzambi there. Who got the name of Nzambi? Only people beyond the river of Ethiopia. The Most High is calling them my dispersed, my worshiper. Okay, my suppliant, my dispersed, he's calling them. This is the people of the Bible. You can get around this. What you're looking for? That's why the book of Daniel we've just read, Daniel 12 and 10, the wicked will not understand. Why are you looking for information to the wicked? To the wicked. And the wicked is scholars. They will tell you, oh, his name was like this. His name, it was like this. And you got Egyptologists will tell you, oh, we are all Africans from Egypt. You got people teaching in the internet telling that, oh, all Africans were Egyptians. You see how lies are going on. So you have to be careful. You come back to the Koma, to the Bible, which is your heritage. You see the word Nzambi here. Nzambi is here in the Bible. This is 16:11, Apocrypha. First Ezra 9, you jump to 30. You got 30. Nzambi. Who are these people called Nzambi? Priest and Levite. Nzambi, you got the word Nzambi here. First Ezra 9:34, you got the name Nzambi. Nzambi is in the Bible. Who got the name Nzambi? Only Bantu people. 34. And when you jump to, who bore the name of Nzambi? Who was called Nzambi? The priest and Levite. You see here, 37 is telling you the priest of here, that's where of Israel. That's where of Israel. So this name is of Israel. It means that this name is of Israel. When you read this scripture, it's telling Levite who went off taking strange wives. This is the list of Levite who went off taking strange wives. Among this Levite, you got Nzambi, priest and Levite, who were called Nzambi. These names are well of the Israel, of Israel. The origin of this name is Israelite names. You think what I mean? Nzambi is an Israelite name. When you say to somebody, oh, you know my name is Nzambi, I'm a Semite. You will tell, oh, Nzambi is not a Semite name. It's his African name. When you say Yaounde, I'm Yaounde. Yaounde is an African name, but Yaounde is not an African name. It's a Bantu name. It is in the Bible. It means Judah. But people will change it. Yaounde. Yaounde. Even his name. When you come the name of Jesus, when you come to the name of Jesus, and what the wicked will do? Because the wicked will not understand the wicked will do. The name Zami, you go to Bible tool, the name Zami was changed. Look, King James Version, the Revised Version, British and America, okay, the Revised changed it to Nzambri. It became Nzambri. Why they changed the name who was before Nzambi, and they changed it to New, the Revised Version, British and America, they changed this name Nzambi to Nzambri. What revised mean? Revised, the word revised means change. Changed. Why they changed the name Nzambi to Nzambri? The true Bible is telling you that the revised versions of the Bible changed the name of Nzambi from Nzambi to Nzambri. They had air for it not to look like a Zambia, for people to wake up. Okay? You understand? Zambia, Nzambi. You did what I mean. That's the great secret kept to you by the wicked, which is Esau. So, my people, be fully blessed. We're going to come back to break down at the scripture. But today, now you know that the people living beyond the river of Ethiopia got the secret. Okay, they are the people of Nzambi. Nzambi is not an African name. It is a semi-Bantu name. Okay? And the wicked, which is Esau, changed the name to Nzambri in order to mislead the people. Okay? But the name of your God is in the Bible. You find it here in Nzambi. And this name was the name of priest and Levite. That's where of Israel. Okay? That's where of Israel. Okay? They were Israelite. It is an Israelite name. If you call your son, you can call him Nzambi. It is good. Okay? Salama to everybody. We will come back with other videos. Be fully blessed. Beluka to everyone of you. Salama.